Did you know that the only weapon in John Hayes Hammond Jr.'s collection of medieval and Renaissance artifacts is a 16th century German Zweihänder sword? Contrary to what one might assume of a man who built a Gothic-style castle as his home and museum, Mr. Hammond did not focus on collecting medieval arms and armaments. While he was very much interested in the weapons of the future, inventing radio-controlled torpedoes among other instruments of war, he had little interest in the weapons of the past. He preferred collecting religious items. Over the years, Hammond Castle Museum has housed several examples of medieval weaponry and armor, but almost all of it has consisted of either replica pieces or items not in Mr. Hammond's original collection. The Zweihänder is the sole exception, and was a gift from Clarence H. McKay, a friend of Hammond's, a financier and president of the McKay Radio and Telegraph Company. McKay was a collector of medieval weapons and armor, some of which he donated to the Metropolitan Museum of Art in New York. His gift of the Zweihänder was reluctantly accepted by Hammond, and is currently located in the museum's Great Hall. Zweihänders are known for their impressive size. This example is roughly 6 feet in length. Despite this, like most medieval swords that preceded its development, it is surprisingly lightweight, only weighing about 7 pounds. The reason for this is that heavyweight swords would be slow and impractical to wield in battle, especially paired with the heavy plate armor that was in common use by the late Middle Ages. Upon close inspection, one can see that the blade is quite thin. The two spikes protruding out of the blade are known as parrying hooks, or parierhaken, which could be used to snare the weapon of an opponent. The weapon was wielded with both hands due to its large size. Its German name, Zweihänder, can be translated to two-hander, and it was historically more often known as a Doppelhander, double-hander, Beidhander, Beihander, or Beidenhander, both-hander. A highly skill-based infantry weapon, its wielders often received double the pay of normal soldiers. It saw its most effective use during the 16th and 17th centuries, and was known throughout the Low Countries, Italian city-states, and became most identified with the Germans and Swiss. Despite its intimidating looks and reputation, the Zweihänder did not remain in military use for exceptionally long, as it became increasingly impractical with the evolution of European warfare in the 17th and 18th centuries, eventually evolving into a more ceremonial weapon. Swords in general were less effective in real combat than many types of competing weapons in the medieval period, but retained a strong symbolic value that persists to this day. Hopefully you found this video more interesting than Hammond would have. We hope you enjoyed this video, but there's a lot more to explore about John Hayes Hammond Jr., his inventions, and his collection of art and artifacts. We invite you to visit us at Hammond Castle Museum in Gloucester, Massachusetts, to learn more.